Alright, hello stellar people, and welcome back to the channel, where we are doing part 3 of Beautiful Bee's Kiss Pounce. This is the clean inks. I also did some detailing with some pen, and the program that I'm using today is Clip Studio Paint, which I use when I'm not using Photoshop. But what I like about Clip Studio Paint is that it has a lot of options when it comes to painting, inks and whatnot, and also comic work. But today, here we have it. But I just wanted to go over one thing, is that this is the original size. Let me once again duplicate it, duplicate layer, because I always duplicate things. Now, what I like about Clip Studio Paint is that it makes a transparency that you can paint underneath, that I do things a little differently than in Photoshop, because I like the painting. So when you have it, scan it, bring it in, and bring it in by import image. And then you find the image and you open it. All right, that's that. So here it is. And usually I, you know, in Photoshop, multiply, then go on a layer underneath that and then paint. But in Clip Studio Paint, what I do is I rasterize the layer. And then when you rasterize it, okay, it's done doing that. Then there is convert brightness to opacity. Convert brightness to opacity under the edit. And now, once it does its thing, there you go, then I can paint underneath it. So I also have my color swatches that I have for Beautiful Bee's Kiss colors, so that I can quickly grab them. We go to the layer underneath, create a new layer, and then we paint. So what I like to do is make a base lasso tool, and then I'll, you know, go lasso all of it and then paint. Okay. So, and it don't have to be exact, but I like to get it somewhat. We just want the overall shape. I'm going quicker than I usually go, but this is a, what would you call it? A demo, somewhat. But I've kind of gotten comfortable with, although I haven't used it in a while, because I've been doing a lot of Photoshop work for the channel. But I quite like Clip Studio Paint. But again, use whatever program you feel the most comfortable way. Okay. We want the complete outline. be exact, but I'll have enough of it that I can do the thing that I need to do. Keep on the road. Keep on the road. I was never a very good coloring book kid. My brother could color within the lines. I could not. And yet, I'm the artist. Very, very odd. Okay, almost got it. Almost got it. And there. Okay. So, we have the outline around the entire thing. We're on the color level. And, well, wait, I need to do eyedropper. Eyedropper, I usually make it a base orange. A base orange. So, eyedropper, select it, then the B. And I usually use dense watercolor. And I color it. And there we have, and this is the base coat. Okay. And then I usually separate the other individual parts and then color those. But let's start doing some slight bit of that. So let's see. Let's do the wings first. B. And then I try not to go into the parts. Try to get close without encroaching. What I like about also lips is, you know, the pressure. It's pressure sensitive, so darker, deeper colors if you press hard enough. Okay, so now let's do the under, right, the under close. So that would be the under, well, and what else? The athletic wear under the dress. Anklet. And what else? For her armlet. Armlet. This other armlet is light. Light blue, yes. And let's again for odd. She jumps from dimension to dimension. So odd dimensions, she only has one color, and even dimensions, she has two bands. So she's in an even dimension. This is just nonsense I made up to keep things straight in my mind. Wings. And let's do the green. Her top is a lighter green. Again, this is all just made up stuff. Rules for this design to keep things straight in my head. Okay. And then her dress is a slightly darker version. Okay. Her hair is an orange color. So I do that. Darker than her body color. So and I usually start with midtones so that I can go darker and lighter. For highlights and all of that. Okay. Let's do her eyebrows. But usually I'll make her eyebrows the stripe color. So we'll do that. And that is a darker brownish color. And I forgot to put her stripes on. Except for her face. So we'll make it up. Usually I have some along her arm. And sometimes. And across her belly, or her midsection, I should say. Did do it on her legs though, so. And that is something. And is that? I'm trying to make her stripes do different things on different arms. Just because. Okay, that's that. Now let's do her eyes. Which do I make it? light blue. For the whites of her eyes. And the teeth. Oops. Her eyes are green. And also the gem on her arm is also green. Let's do the nails. Her nails are a darker color. And her toenails or toe claws. Okay, is that blocked in? I think so. And so now we deselect. Command D, deselect it. Always save, kids. Command S to save. Okay, so let's clean up some areas. And I'm just taking the eyedropper and picking on the colors to get those. I'm decent at digital color. I'd like to get a lot better. And I have plans for that. And I might do something for the channel, but I'm not sure exactly what. Eye tool, select the color, then the brush tool, and then you paint. And you paint. And the brush, the eye tool, select the color, B is for the brush tool. So there's a lot of crossover for between Photoshop and Clip Studio Paint. Eye drop and brush tool. Let's do those stripes on the tail. Eye tool. For the eyedropper, select the color, then the B tool, and or paint. Okay. Now, eyedropper, dress, B tool. But you get the idea. You get the idea. Okay, so also, I usually wait until the end, right? After I can be messy to go back to the lasso tool. I'm sorry, the marquee tool. The M. M brings up the lasso in Clip Studio. And that's sometimes the problem where you can't quite remember what I do in one program isn't quite the same as another program. but you start to get it. And then once you have that area selected, then you hit delete and it'll delete all that. And then Command D to deselect. And so that's pretty much, right? These are pretty much the colors. Now it's just a lot of tinkering. This is pretty much it. And then I select the colors that I've already pre-made with the eyedropper tool. And then I paint. Now would be a great time to select where your light's coming from. If your light's coming from, you know, here, right? If the light's here, then this area would be darker. Or you could do a side up, right? And over, and then if, you know, this side would be darker. So select your color, your light source. Or you could also have two light sources, one and then another. Like this would be your main light and this would be your secondary light. So say if this is a warm sunlight, maybe a purplish or a bluish maybe, but yeah, depends on what you want. And sometimes, just like in painting, from a mid-tone, right? You have a mid-tone, it's easier to spot colors, right, than a straight white. But a mid-tone is what, like a gray or neutral, and then it's a push and pull between darks and lights, darks and lights. At least that's the philosophies that, you know, they try to put into us in oil paintings or paintings of any kind, really. Oops. What are you doing, Trey? What are you doing? It's all a play between darks and lights. Shadow forms, highlights, and all. Thank you. I think is that. So that is a beautiful Beast Kiss pounce, a simplified, because you could take this as far as you wish, right? You could just keep on, you know, work on it for a week, you could work on it for a month, however long you feel it would take to get it to where you want it. But for an hour demonstration, this is pretty much what I got. All right. Okay, so for a recap of the whole process, we started with a thumbnail. A thumbnail, a gesture sketch. We took from all of these gesture sketches. We selected one, and that would be our jumping off point. We enlarged it, blew it up, faded back, and I draw on top of it, right? You're doing construction lines on top of that gesture sketch to flesh it out, develop it more, see what you can see in it and try to bring that out. And so I printed that out and then drew on top of that. So this is like step three. And red and blue pencil. The blue is more construction and the redder is some detailing and tightening up. And this is pretty much the process for me if I don't want to keep it in computer. And so then I inked it. So in inking, I select all the lines that I want, isolate those, try to improve on the initial sketch. You add details, you add folds, you add stripes, fingernails, hair, eyes, all of it. Right? And with the clean ink, I like a clean ink, so then I can take it into, say if I wanted to digital paint it, I could also take these clean inks to watercolor or another physical medium. But the inks are an essential phase. And then this is the final. This is the color. I did this digitally, but again, you could also do this physical. And it kind of pulls it all together. Color unifies and brings it all, more or less brings it to life. And that is the best part about doing color, is that, you know, the audience has a frame of reference, you know, in their mind. From an ink sketch, you can't tell what certain things are, like what is she wearing? What color is the thing she wearing? What color are her eyes? What color is her hair? Body color, wings, and all of that. And that brings it all together, the color. And that was the process. All of the steps, from thumbnail to enlarging to drawing on top to inking, ink to colors, and this is the final. So I hope that was interesting to someone. And I will see you on the next episode. Take care and keep shining. Later.